Hi viewers, welcome to my channel Sudha Biology. And in this session, I would like to discuss about the TI plasmid vector, which is a mediated a genetic transfer, so genetic transformation in plants. So the vector which is used especially in case of plant cells, so that is called as TI plasmid vector, which is isolated from Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So Agrobacterium tumefaciens, which contains a plasmid that is called as TI plasmid, so which is used for carrying our desired DNA and introducing into the plant cells. So especially this is called as plant natural vector, which does not cause any harm to the plants. So it is not at all pathogenic to the plant cells. So the TI plasmid structure, which contains a tDNA, which is called as transfer DNA, and this is able to induce tumors in plant cells. So this is able to induce tumors in plant cells. So Agrobacterium tumefaciens, which contains this vector, it is used for causing crown gall disease in plants. So this tDNA, which is present here, it induces tumors in plant cells. So this is a structure of TI plasmid, which contains tDNA, that is also called as transfer DNA, which is able to induce tumors in the plant cells. So now we are ligating our desired DNA. So first we isolate the vector from bacterium, that is TI plasmid vector, and now we are isolating our desired DNA and cutting the desired DNA. So this is our desired DNA. Say for example, take a stress resistant gene from the plants, which are able to tolerate the stress, and we are using the same restriction endonuclease enzyme to cut our desired DNA as well as even the vector. Okay, and now we are ligating our desired DNA in the tDNA region. So that is ligation of our desired DNA into the tDNA of TI plasmid. So now after ligating, this is nothing but a recombinant DNA. So this recombinant DNA, after ligating of our desired DNA into the vector, it is being transformed again into the host cell. So that is into the bacterial cell again. So it is not into the host cell, it is being transformed. The recombinant DNA is being again sent back into the or reinserted into the bacterium, that is Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So it is being again sent to Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So this is with the desired DNA, and that is being reinserted into the Agrobacterium organism. So that is Agrobacterium, we are being reinserting this recombinant DNA. And then this bacterium is used for transfer of this tDNA, which is carrying the desired DNA, into the plant cells. So now we are transferring this into the plant cells. So these are the plant cells which have started growing. So these are the plant cells which are taking up this tDNA with the desired DNA, which is being carried along with the tDNA. So bacterium is used to transfer this the tDNA, which is carrying the desired DNA, into the plant cells. So now the plant cells which are growing in this culture medium have taken up this desired DNA, which is ligated with the tDNA, and now that is able to induce tumors in the plant cells. So the genes which are being useful, that is stress resistant genes, which will be multiplied in this region, that is because tDNA, which is able to induce tumors in the plant cells, so which is no more causing harm to the plant cells, it is not at all pathogenic to plant cells. And that plant which is being developed by introduction of foreign gene into this plant as a host, so that plant we call it as transgenic plant. So this is how Agrobacterium tumefaciens, which contains TI plasmid, which is containing tDNA, is used for transferring our desired DNA into the plant cells. That is host cell, here it is nothing but plant cells. So the plant which is being grown by expressing that gene, and that is called as transgenic plant. So any plant which is being carrying the foreign gene, or which is being inserted with a foreign gene, so that plant we term it as transgenic plant. So this plant which is developed is called as transgenic plant with a foreign gene along with the tDNA is being introduced into this host plant. That plant is called as transgenic plant. Similarly, one more vector which is used for plants, it is Agrobacterium rhizotiles. So Agrobacterium tumefaciens is one bacterium which contains DNA plasmid vector. So similarly, even Agrobacterium rhizogenes, so another bacterium, is also used in order to induce tumors in plant cells, or in order to induce, especially in case of roots in plants. So two vectors which are majorly used in case of plants. So Agrobacterium tumefaciens, which contains TA plasmid, is a natural vector for plants. So similarly, in case of animals, the retrovirus vector is used in order to carry a foreign gene. So what is a vector? It is nothing but a cloning vehicle which is transferring a desired DNA or our desired gene into the host cells. So that is nothing but vector. So here our vector for plant cells, it is nothing but TA plasmid vector, which contains a tDNA, that is transfer DNA, for transferring our desired DNA into the plant cells. Thank you.